Okay, well, good morning. It is Saturday morning. We're having a rainy day and we're in Seattle. So I think we're right on target for an April Saturday in Seattle. Welcome. This is our Saturday morning pre-dance class. Our theme this week has been springtime. So I've been doing some things with April showers, bring May flowers. So I think it's really appropriate that it's raining today. So welcome, good to see you. As I always mention, the classes are being recorded. So if you're catching this a little later on, enjoy taking class along with us. We've been reading through the story this week of the little ballerinas. So just a reminder, I do have classes Mondays and then Tuesdays and then Saturdays, and I'm just gonna keep it rolling like that. We'll have a new theme for next week. But let's go ahead and get started and our traditional marching song. Here we go. Everybody up to your feet. Let's march. And add a clap. Hands on hip center. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and turn. March 1, 2, 3, passe. 1, 2, 3, passe. So bringing the foot up to the knee, that helps to warm up your body, but we're also remembering to point our toes when the foot leaves the floor. So sideways, 1, 2, 3, my foot is pointed. It's coming up all the way to the side of the knee. 1, 2, 3, passe. Thank you for putting on your pink leotard to be ready for ballet class. Miss Debbie has on her black dance wear today. All right, let's practice with our feet, our turnout, and our parallel. Ready? Heels together. Open your feet. Close. We open. We close. We open. We close. One more time. Open and stay open. There's our ballet first position. Heels are kissing. We're standing tall. We have our princess crown on our heads. Lovely kings and queens in class today. All right, let's hold our balloons in front of us. Knees open and close. Knees open and close. Knees open and close. And in ballet, what do we call this one? We call that the plie. Ready? We plie. And stretch it straight. We plie. And stretch it straight.
Not yet.
Plie. And stretch it straight.
You ready? Put it on.
You ready?
And weave.
Beautiful. I'm going to stretch and point one foot out to the side. Start your PK. A little point. Pretending we are putting polka dots on the floor. Good morning. As more and more dancers join, I'll just keep waving and saying welcome to class. So good to see you. Love to see you, girls.
All right, Kayla.
First, other foot. Out to the side. So we're balancing on one foot. All the way up until only your toes are touching the floor. Hold your circle and PK. Beautiful. So we're pretending that we are painting little polka dots on the floor. Lovely. And pull those heels back together in reverse. So thank you so much. I can tell you're very good professional dancers. That's awesome. Okay, let's do hands on our hips. We've done our marching. We've done our PK.
Talk to them.
And we've done the releve.
Alright, mommy's going to do it. Just follow her. Mommy's going to do it.
So let's close those toes together so we're parallel.
Can you guys mute your mic, please?
I think we do little bounces. Ready? Bounce. And everybody reach up as high as you can. Tall. Alrighty, let's have a seat on our carpet or a mat, whatever you're working on today. I just want to greet everybody. So traditionally, even though we're in Zoom classroom and we can't be here to hug each other, I'm so happy to see your faces. we always start with the same marching song because we might hear that music that's familiar. It's like, oh, that reminds me of when I was taking dance class with one of the teachers at Reflections. It's the same music. But I'm so glad to see the dancers are taking your classes with seriousness. You've got your leotards on, you're ready to go. So I'm Miss Debbie. I know some of my girls are used to taking class with Miss Katie or Miss Kristen or Miss Olivia or Miss Sarah. So for now, we'll do our Zoom classes with Miss Debbie. Our theme this week has been springtime. And that's what I mentioned earlier before some of the girls came onto camera. So the phrase we're using this week is April showers, like it's raining today. So if you were to go outside, you might have an umbrella with you. April showers bring May flowers. That's a little phrase from an old poem. It means as we look through the calendar, this is the month of April. There's going to be a lot of rain, but that's good news because when the calendar changes to the month of May, all the beautiful flowers start to open up. Some of you maybe already have daffodils and tulips in your yard. And Miss Debbie has a lot of flowers in her yard too. I'm excited to see that. So that's our theme. So as we go through warming our bodies and doing our stretching, I'll keep talking to you about some of the elements of springtime. Okay? So first of all, we're gonna do crisscross applesauce. You girls show me. Does everybody remember crisscross? Feet tucked underneath, we're sitting nice and tall. Good. Reach in front of you and find a beautiful crown. Can you place it up on your head? And in your imagination, think what color it is. All right. Okay, give me thumbs up if you're thinking of a special color that your crown is. Okay, thumbs up. Everybody, okay, awesome. I have my color inside my mind too. It's my imagination. I've got my crown on. And as we go through the next exercise, which is slow stretching, I'm gonna see if I can keep sitting tall and balancing that crown up on my head. Okay, this is so good for our posture. I'm so glad that you girls are doing your ballet because it's fun, but it's also so good for our posture. Okay, there's our slow music. Let's take our arms out to the side, second position. One arm curving over the head. And open back to second, still sitting tall. Second arm curving overhead. And back to second, sitting tall. Two arms in, ballet first position when you hold a circle in front of you. So good. And let's make that circle a little bigger, a little bigger, a little bigger, till we're back to second position. Okay, ready? One arm curving overhead. And back to second, still sitting tall. Other arm curving overhead. And back to second, sitting tall. Ready, two arms curving overhead. And back to second. And closing in front of you, there's first position, holding that circle. Beautiful. All right, side stretch, one hand on the mat, one arm out to second, and big reach over the top. This is when we say, good morning, neighbor. So wave to the person that's beside you, only in your imagination. And let's wave to each other on the camera. Good, back to second. Let's go the other side. Other hand on the mat, big stretch up over the top. Oh, that's such a good big reach. I love it. Good morning to your friends in your imagination. And then good morning to the friends on the camera. We're so glad you're here. Okay, let's do that one again. Ready, arms in second, one hand on the mat, big reach to the side, and back to center. Other hand on the mat, big reach to the side, and back to center. And here's a really tricky one. Two hands up, two hands down in front of you, and heads towards the front. And sitting back up tall, head coming up last. Good. In case your crown fell off, let's place it back on. Good. Alrighty, good stretching. I love it. Okay, we're gonna do something for our legs. Last week when I did the story, we were using Dr. Seuss's The Foot Book, and we learned some new exercises to help warm up our feet. So I'm gonna scoot backwards. So I think you can all see my feet. I don't have my ballet shoes on. I just have my socks on here today. They're stretched and they're pointed. Then if I show you my heels, the toes are looking back towards me, then the feet are flexed. But last week we learned a new one, which is in between pointed and flexed. It's called demi-point. So I pushed half of my foot out, and then you just see the toes and the ball of my foot. So if I turn sideways, you see my feet are not pointed, but they're also not flexed. It's halfway. That's called our demi point. And for most preschoolers, when we're moving around on the floor, we lift our heels off the floor, we work on our demi point, not our full point. Okay? So we're gonna do our exercise today for that. I'm gonna be saying pointed, turned out, flexed, together, then we're adding in demi point, full point, turn out, flex, together, and then without bending your knees, you reach out and tap your toes, okay? Hello, toes, good morning, toes. Here we go. Okay, sitting tall, toes pointed. Let's turn out, heels still kissing. Let's flex. Toes together into parallel. And tap those toes. Wake up, toes. Push to demi point. Push to full point. And we're back where we began. Let's turn out. Let's flex. Bring the toes together into parallel. Wake up, toes. Good morning. Tap those toes. And pushing to demi point. And full point. And you're back where you began. Good. All right. Well, I'm going to scoot forward because it is our story time. Okay? I'll come a little close to the camera because I want you to be able to see the pages of the book. But on Monday and Tuesday, we started reading this story called The Little Ballerina. The main characters are two girls named Emily and Hannah. And Emily and Hannah love ballet. They started taking class together. One girl is very confident and she loves to do ballet and she's very good at it. The other girl doesn't feel as confident and she's still a good dancer, but she's not quite sure about herself. So her friend is encouraging her. What's happened so far is there was a professional ballerina came and she had an audition and she told the girls to practice their arabesque. So I'll show you the picture. The girls were working very hard. They were out in the park and even though dance class was over, they kept working hard to do arabesque. So here they are. They're not wearing their ballet clothes. They're wearing their boots and their jackets and they're at the park practicing really hard. So Emily says to Hannah, the most important thing to remember is that dancing is fun. By the end of that week, Hannah started to believe what Emily had told her. The two friends practiced together every day, and Emily made sure that they shared lots of laughs. So there they are. There's one day, there's the next day, there's the next day. And on this day, it's probably Friday, they're giggling and laughing because they're having so much fun dancing together. Taylor, can you see it? You can, yeah, good. All right, good. Good to see you girls. All righty. Now, they've made it back to the dance studio and their arabesque is looking so good because they were practicing it at the park. And that's kind of the way it is for us at Reflection School of Dance. You might be at home in your living room or you're in your backyard, but you could still practice your arabesque. And by the time we come back to the dance studio, it's going to look better than it did when you took class before. It says, on the day that the prima ballerina's visit came, each pair of dancers showed her what they could do. At last, it was Emily and Hannah's turn. When Emily smiled at her, Hannah thought of how much fun they had had dancing, and so she smiled back. She gave the biggest smile of all when they danced the arabesque together. So girls, let me see your faces. Can you show me a big smile just like Emily and Hannah do? Oh, beautiful, beautiful smiles. So that's something that we add to our dancing too. We dance with our bodies, but we also want to dance with our faces. It's important that we share our joy. Oh, those are beautiful smiles. I love it. All righty, one more page. It says, Isabella Ponte congratulated all the girls on their hard work. She said, you all performed really well.
So you haven't made my choice easy. But there's one pair of dancers that stands out. They work together very well, and they smile at each other. And they made me feel that they find dancing to be fun. I'm choosing Emily and Hannah. Well, that's exciting. So we're not going to read the whole story today. Each day in Zoom class, we're reading one or two pages. But we can see that what happened was Emily and Hannah got better at their arabesque, and they were chosen by the professional dancer to be in the show because she noticed how much joy that they had. All right? So we are going to stand up. I'm going to use a chair. If you have a chair or something to hold on to, you can pretend it's your ballet bar. But if you don't have anything, you could just put your hands on your hips. We're going to do our arabesque exercise, just like Emily and Hannah did. So I've got my chair. I'm going to be standing sideways to my chair, feet in ballet first position. One hand is reaching for the chair. The other hand is on my hip. But if you don't have a chair, you can put both hands on your hips, and it's really good for your balance, okay? All right, I'm going to put the music on. When the music begins, we stretch to tendu, and then we lift the foot off the floor into dégagé. Then without dropping the foot, you're going to draw a line from the front to the side. You're still balancing on one foot, and we'll do one pique. Pique. Then without moving your foot, you're going to rotate your body. So now my hips and my tummy are looking towards my chair. They're looking to the front, and I'm going to pique again. And there I am in arabesque. Look at you, dancers, beautiful. And then I drop the foot and closing heels back together. Okay. Now what will be a little bit tricky, dancers, is because then I'm going to do the other foot. I'll be facing away from you for just a second. So you're going to see Miss Debbie's back. But that gives you a chance to practice your right foot and your left foot. It looks like more dancers are joining us. So welcome, Raina. Welcome any dancers that are logging on. We are practicing our arabesque right now with a chair or a little bar, or even the coffee table will work. On your front, lift the dégagé. Carry it to the side, pique. Rotate to reach your chair, pique. And hold that arabesque. And close, another side. So pick your favorite color of what your umbrella is going to be, and then you're going to pick it up and hold it up over your head. When it sounds like the rain is stopping and I think the sun's coming out, I'm going to pick up the flowers. And I'm, oh, they're beautiful smelling flowers. And the flowers bloom because all the rain came down out of the sky. So it's a little story that we're doing with a little dance. Alrighty, let's sit on our knees. Close your eyes for just a second. Hear the music. Open your eyes and put the sun in the sky. Arms in fifth position. And as the sun gets warmer, it feels like it's getting bigger and bigger and bigger, because sometimes we see sunshine in springtime. And let's hold those arms in front of us. Lumba. I hear some birds. So we're going to cross our thumbs and make bird wings. Can you make some birds for me? The birds are chirping. Springtime is the time when baby animals are born and little baby birds come out of the eggs in their nests. Let's see if we can make those birds fly. I hear something. Put your hand to your ear. Listen. I think there might be a rainstorm coming. Let's bring some water down out of the sky. Here come the raindrops. And when you hear the rain hitting the sidewalk, it sounds like this. It's raining!
I wake up, I yawn,
and stretch. Awesome. Good morning, it's
things I have to do every morning when I wake up. I wash my
hands,
and I shave, and brush my teeth. There's so much to do.
You put your toothbrush,
I'm dressed now. I'll make my bed.
Oh, make your bed. That machine.
All set now.
And brush your hair.
My way.
Look in the mirror.
Good morning.
Hey, you look really good. Let's go outside and do a happy dance. All right, heels together. Top work drop. Slowly, the sun's coming up. First thing in the morning.
I really like morning time.
That's beautiful.
The sun's just come up. The day is good. That puts me in the mood to start getting things done. All set now. My bed is ready.
My bed is safe.
My hair is fresh.
My hair is fresh.
To go on my way.
Bye, Mom. I'm heading out. Look in the mirror. Look in the mirror. You look really good. Let's go out. Do the happy dance. So, I'm going to ask you a question, and it's actually okay if your mic's off and I can't hear you because I can see you, but I want you to think something that you do the first thing in the morning. Maybe you put on clean clothes. Maybe you brush your teeth. Maybe your first thing is to go down and have breakfast with your mom. So can you think of one thing you do in the morning, even before dance class? Awesome. So that's kind of what this dance is about. And we're gonna do it one more time. And there's another part of the dance. The music went really fast, we missed it. But he says, I wash my hands and face and I brush my teeth. Okay, we did the toothbrush. But then Junior, he's saying, button the shirt and tie the shoes. So that's one part we forgot, and that's okay. Well, we'll do it again, okay? So same dance, but now a little bit bigger. So you can go back to your mats or your carpets, put your pretend jammies on.
Well, it's 10 o'clock.
There's the alarm, wake up! Oh, rub your eyes and stretch.
Oh, hi, it's me, Bob. It's 7 o'clock here in Cincinnati.
7 o'clock.
And it's time to get up.
Hands on the mat. Stand up. Let's march. It's time to get up.
Hot rings. I wake up. I yawn. I stretch myself. Good morning.
It's 7 o'clock near you. Help me, Mom. I need Mom calls. I wake up. Get up then. Start getting dressed. Good morning.
There are lots of things I have to do every morning when I wake up. I wash my hands and face and I shave and brush my teeth. There's so much to do.
Each morning, I get out of bed and wash up, and then I get dressed. Put on my shirt and do my own buttons. I can even tie my own shoe. Well, almost. Sometimes.
I'm dressed now. I'll make my bed.
I'm dressed now. I'll brush my hair.
All set now. To go in my way.
Just look in the mirror.
Good morning. Such a good feeling.
Let's go outside and do happy dance.
I'm going out today.
Morning time because the sun's just come up, the day is new, and it kind of puts me in the mood to start getting things done. All set now, my bed is made.
All set now, my hair is fresh.
I'm ready to go on my way.
Just look in the mirror.
Good morning, such a good feeling.
Happy dance.
I have a feeling I'm going to lie today.
Smile! Yay!
Now is the time to
walk.
Well, girls, we only have a couple of minutes left in our class time, but we've talked about time. It's springtime. It's rainy, the flowers are blossoming, but there's always a special time. It doesn't matter if it's morning, afternoon, or when it is. Now is the time to worship. So that's the next song we have. And if people don't understand what worship is, it's like God created the universe, and the way we want to say thank you to him, or we give our attention to God because we're so glad that we even have life. And so anytime is the time to worship. I'm going to grab the scarves, and I know scarf dance is one of the favorite times for any kids in preschool. If you have a t-shirt or any kind of fabric, or you can even, if your mom doesn't mind you borrowing the pillow, take the pillow off the couch, and we're going to use those props for come now to come to worship. All right, I've got this lavender one today. Anything you have, even your hands are just fine. You can use your hands. You don't have to have a special prop. So Taylor, whatever you have is totally fine. Just use your arms. And I noticed you have your kitty cat ears on today. Even your ears can worship.
Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart.
So where's your heart? Can you put your hands on your heart?
Yes, if you are.
And we give our heart to God.
Now is the time to worship.
And if you want to try it with a scarf or whatever you have, you can.
Now is the time to give your heart.
Beautiful. So creative. I love the things that you grab to use. That's perfect. I love it. Mom, are you going to worship with us? She's got the tiniest little mini skirt on. Hi, good to see you. All right, here we go. Up over the top. That's perfect. You girls are so creative. Can we make circles? Heels together, plie, and stretch, and plie, and stretch, and plie, and stretch. One more. Oh, let's get to second position. You got it. Good. Plie, and stretch, and plie. Maybe you want to put mom and dad, maybe we put Miss
There's your prayers, and let's push them up to God. Thank you, God, for hearing our prayers today. Thank you that people won't be sick anymore.
What just happened with this?
It is Saturday, April 25th.
Okay, let's try that one again. Music cut out. Ready? Whatever you put in your hands, we're going to give that to God. Thank you, God, for listening to our prayers. And let's do our curtsy, okay? Because our time is almost up, girls. Ready? One foot front, one to the side. Thank you, teacher. Thank you, Miss Debbie. Other foot, front, side. Thank you, dancers. It was so good to have you here today. Now with arms, thank you to God. Arms front, open to the side, and curtsy. Thank you, God, for protecting us and keeping us safe. Let's clap for a really good class today. Thank you, girls. Bye, I'll see you next time. We love you. We're glad that you're here today. Thank you.